this video, I'll go over a few small selection enhancements in HST toolpaths for Mastercam 2022, along with the ability to set cut stepover by degree. Let's OptiRough this BattleBot wheel file. There's already a stock model to create an OptiRough toolpath from. In our machining geometry selection, let's create some additional machining and avoidance geometry groups. Click the Add New Group button to create another machining group. Name it Machining 2. Change the selection surface color to yellow and set wall and floor stock to 0.5 millimeters. Now, the right-click menu has some more functionality. Right-clicking on the group allows you to select the geometry directly from the menu, along with the ability to unselect all the entities from here. Before, you had to enter the selection window, then click Clear Selection. Also in the menu is an Add Remaining Entities button, which is useful when you have made all of your selections for areas you want to machine, and add the remainder as avoidance geometry. Select these surfaces under the group named Machining Geometry. Let's select these other surfaces for the Machining 2 geometry. And we can right-click on the avoidance geometry group and click Add Remaining Entities. Under Toolpath Control, select this solid edge of the part. Set the strategy to stay inside. For our tool, select Tool 1, the 12 mm flat end mill, and name the operation OptiRough. In the Stock tab, enable Rest Material and leave it on All Previous Operations. Going over to the cut parameters, we can see an angle field under Stepover. This value is linked to the Stepover linear distance. For instance, a 90-degree cutting angle equates to 50% stepover. Some cutting tool manufacturers specify an ideal stepover angle instead of a distance in their catalogs. We'll set this value to 60 degrees, which corresponds to a 25% stepover. Choose a 200% step down and set step ups to 10%. Under Steep Shallow, check Maximum Depth and select this lower surface edge. Click OK to regenerate. Let's create a waterline toolpath to finish this sprocket. We will close out of this dialog for a second to look at the toolpaths manager. Click Cancel and click Yes to keep this operation. Make sure the selection is on the waterline toolpath and right-click and drag the geometry from the OptiRough operation to the waterline geometry. Now in Mastercam 2022, the previous selection and avoidance groups along with their respective stock-to-leave values can be copied between operations. This can be very useful when importing an operation with common stock-to-leave values to save time from reselecting machining and avoidance surfaces. Select Replace Geometry and Stock-to-Leave Values for all selected operations. Go back to the Waterline toolpath and select Tool 2, the Ball Nose End Mill. Click OK and generate the toolpath.